Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening, friends. Let's get into the next question. I'm in page 106, Accountancy Volume 1, Illustration 7, Lectures. Prepare cash account from the following transactions for the month of January 2018. Commence the business with cash. As usual, we have to prepare journal entries. Or let's straight away try and put the ledgers. The best approach is to have journal entries done first so that we don't miss any transaction. Let's continue with the journal entries. Commence business with cash. So, cash account debit to capital account. Capital account credit. So, cash account debit is 62,000. Generalizing is always better to understand the flow of transactions, and will not miss any transactions, because journal entries, as you know, are prepared basis the source documents. Next is goods purchased for cash. Purchases account debit cash account credit 12,000. Third entry is goods sold for cash 10,000. So, cash account debit, sales account credit 10,000. Next entry is wages paid 4,000. So, wages being expense account, nominal account, wages account, debit to cash, cash account credit 4,000. Furniture purchased for cash. So, furniture account, real account, for furniture account debit. Cash account credit. Furniture purchase for cash 6,000 rupees. Now let's prepare at the ledger. I'm copying the format from the earlier file. To retain the format, I'm just copying this format. Pasting it here. So. Ledger, cash account, ledger for cash account. Okay, so what are all the transactions coming in? To capital account, 62,000. Second entry is purchases goods for by cash 12,000 rupees. By purchases 12,000. Then cash account to sales account 10,000. And wages account to cash by wages 4,000. Furniture account to cash by furniture 6,000. So, total balance, debit side of the cash book is 72,000 and credit side is, what is the total difference that I am getting here? Balance carried forward. The credit side is 22,000. So, the balance carried forward is 72,000 minus 50,000. So total 70,000. Beginning balance carried forward to the next period is 15,000. Balance carried forward is 50,000. So hope this sum is clear. Let me know if you have any doubts or clarifications so that I can clarify them. Thank you, friends.